In lieu of hiring a musician to sit in the corner of your bedroom and play sad trombone every time you can't get it up, why not choose to laugh it off? Hi, I'm Jerome, resident sex expert at LTA Sex.info. Welcome to Let's Talk About Sex, the show where we talk about sex. And today, for the very first video of Sexual Health Month, we're talking about erectile dysfunction. Now, guys, I know you know that moment where your horny is all hell, about to get it in, and your dick just will not get hard. To the point where no matter how much they lick or touch or kiss or tug, it's nothing's happening. It won't even muster a half salute. It kind of fucking sucks. And you feel like shit when it happens. A bout with ED is a big deal, and it can kill your sexual confidence. But should it? I don't really think so. Now, I've already told you guys about my experiences with depression and ED. When I'm feeling down, everything goes down and stays there. So I've experienced and I understand that embarrassment and sort of disappointment. I mean, you were gonna get it in 5 minutes ago, now you can't even get it hard. Pretty disappointing. That moment when you look down and realize that your little buddy just isn't gonna work is embarrassing as hell. It's sort of like trying to do a backflip and then falling flat on your face in front of everyone you know. And sometimes it feels way worse than that. When you're looking at a night of plastic dick, your mind can get away from you. I mean, you get tunnel vision and all you can see is a soft dick. We forget that erectile dysfunction fucking happens. It just does. Every single man will have to deal with erectile dysfunction at some point in their lives. And if you only get ED once, you're kinda lucky. Erectile dysfunction is common as hell, and your partner knows that. Since you can't avoid ED forever, you might as well just figure out a way to deal with it. In lieu of hiring a musician to sit in the corner of your bedroom and play sad trombone every time you can't get it up, why not choose to laugh it off? If you don't let your soft dick ruin the moment, it's unlikely that your partner will either. And if they do, then don't fuck them. You and your dick don't need their judgmental bullshit. Instead of moping when your cock calls it quits, have a chuckle. And then flip right into making your partner come some other way. Even if perchance they are super disappointed that your cock is out of commission, it is very unlikely that they will object to you spending a night with your face between their legs. Like my girl TLC said, you ain't slanging, just put your tongue in it. Oh. Handjobs are still fun. Mutual masturbation is always an option. How about getting tied up and spanked? Hell, if you're daring, you could try out a routine for puppetry of the penis. The idea here is to let your penis guest star on this episode of Knockin' Boots, so your mind can reconnect with your body and let the blood flow. Most of the time, the anxiety caused by losing your erection is actually what keeps it away. If you relax and have some fun, you might find that your erection is not so elusive after all. And if it still is, who cares? Just keep tonguing it. Have you ever been to a sex toy store? You have options. All right, that's about it for me today. Thank you so much for stopping by. If you like what you saw, make sure to click like or subscribe. If you want to catch up with me, you can do that on Twitter at NotJeromeStewart. You can also send me an email, Jerome@LTASex.info. You can find the Let's Talk About Sex Facebook fan page at facebook.com/LTASexinfo. You can find LTA Sex on Tumblr at LTASex.tumblr.com. For more sexy stuff like this, make sure to check out the blogs at LTASex.info. Once again, thank you so much for stopping by. Until next time, I'm still Jerome. This is still Let's Talk About Sex. And I'll see you next time. Keep it sexy.